To add text to any of your spreads or your cover image, simply double-click on any of the spreads in this window. Here, we are going to add text to the cover, so simply double-click on the cover image and this brings up the cover. For reference, I'm going to bring this image down to curate some white space here at the top. To add my text, we simply click the T logo here and drag the text up. We can double-click on the text area and add the bride and groom's name. Once you have entered the bride and groom name, simply hit return on your keyboard. And this changes the text here. As you can see, it's a little bit large, so we can either click on the logo here with the two smaller T's, and this brings up some options. You can either make the image and text smaller or larger. If you go larger, simply click out of the area, then click on the orange box and drag the drop space. Then, by clicking on this little box here, we can move the text around the cover. Again, you can centralize the text from here and also put it on the right-hand side and the left-hand side. To change the color, simply click on the black icon here and this brings up your sliders and you can literally change everything to suit your color of the album and the theme of the wedding. If you have the RGB values, then simply enter the R, G and B values in this box here. To change the font, simply click on the font side here and you can change from hundreds of different fonts depending on what you have on your PC or Mac. Once you are happy with the size and the texture and the color, simply drag the image back up, and seeing as everything here in Fundy works on layers, we can simply drag and size to suit how we would like the text to be. Some photographers choose to add their logos to the album, and you can do this really easily in Fundy Designer. To import your logo, simply add photos the same way you would if you were adding images to the album. So from here, we need to add in the logo. As you can see, it is a .png file. This means that the logo is transparent. So we click import. What you will find is the logo will not appear in the image well at the bottom. But don't worry, simply click this icon here and this is where you will see all the current PNGs. And here is the logo that we have added. The same way as you would design your album, drag the logo in and resize. If you feel that your logo is too prominent on the cover or spread, simply double click on the logo. Click the spanner icon and this will reduce the opacity of the logo. Some photographers would like to include their logo on their gallery designer as part of their wall art collection. To do this, simply double click on the wall art and drag the logo in the same as you would in Album Builder. And then drag the logo and place where you would like the logo to be. If, for example, you would like to add your logo to the side of a canvas, you can now see we have the safe area, and between this turquoise line and the red line is the area and which will be folded around the canvas. So simply adjust, rotate the logo around, and place between the turquoise and outer edge of the canvas, so when the canvas is folded, your logo will appear on the edge.